I never came back to that topic of why I like the plasticity of the D810 images more than the A7R2 and ended up keeping the D810 at the time. Well, besides the ergonomics issues and stuff, it was because I could abuse the crap out of the files of the D810 in sharpening. Not only the image would not break down, the color would not shift, it would actually improve as crazy as... Okay, so as I said, the D810 pixels had such tremendous plasticity and tolerance that I could sharpen the crap out of them and still no artifacts, no color shifting, check the images at pixel level. As a matter of fact, the color would improve. And I could shoot with a 35 f2D and easily simulate the performance better than the 35 1.4 and the 1.8. And this is the NEF file that you see. I'm gonna close it. And okay, here is what I did with this file. I enlarged it in Photoshop to 100 megapixels and sharpened it. Essentially what you see here, look what I did in the image size. 12,600 pixels by 8,409 pixels. The width now at my monitor's resolution is 91 inches by 60 inches at my monitor's resolution. Okay, so let's see how that looks after the sharpening and everything. Come on. Again, that's an image that was originally shot with the D810. No particular measurements or anything, just a casual snapshot. And the 35mm f2D. Now, some areas are going to be obviously out of focus, but the area that is in focus, look at this performance. Even after the sharpening and a little bit of the clarity filter in ACR, the bricks, they seem like they're popping out. There's a strong 3D effect. I forgot the moral of the story. Number one, choose lenses with low chromatic aberrations. You see how much it helps, especially in magnifications. I did not correct for chromatic aberrations here. It's as it came. The image is going to look much cleaner, more dimensional in many cases. The details are going to be more naturally rendered. Number two, learn Adobe Camera Raw or something like that really well, and you will be amazed at what you will produce with the equipment you already have. You don't need an upgrade. And three, if somebody tells you you need an upgrade because this other thing or system is the future, well, if it's the future, buy it in the future. You know, if it's the future, it's always going to be here. You don't need to rush in to buy it now. If it's the future, it's going to be here 5 months from now, 1 year from now. So you are free to make a choice whenever this result does not satisfy you. I mean, I can make a 13 by 19 out of this little part with the D810 and the 35mm f2D. So consider your options very carefully and do not spend much money. Thanks a lot. Bye.